Hi and welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to use gradients. So to start with, I've got Adobe Illustrator open. I'm going to begin a new document, so I'll click new and I'll just confirm the width and the height and the unit of measurement that I'll use for this. I'm just going to pick web as the profile and I'm going to leave the width and the height as they are and click OK. Okay, so here's my document. Now what I'll do is I'll just create a simple shape like a rectangle, and I want to fill that rectangle with a gradient. So you might use gradients for maybe to create a sky background that might go from dark blue to a lighter blue. It can be anything really, and there's two types of gradients that we'll work with. So I'll start by creating a rectangle. Now this rectangle at the moment has a black stroke color, so the outline will be black and the inside at the moment is just white. So I'm going to draw a rectangle here. It's going to take up most of the document space, and there's my rectangle. Now I can click on the gradient tool down here. So this is the gradient tool right here. And I can click on that to basically draw a gradient on. But I need to actually create my gradient first. So you can either double click on the gradient tool, which will bring up the gradient panel over here if you don't see it, or you can click on window and then gradient to make sure you see the gradient panel. Okay, so firstly you need to select what type of gradient you want to work with, linear or radial. If you select linear, and you might already get a gradient to begin with, so this is just black and white, but if you select linear, it goes from either left to right, or if you click and drag to draw the gradient bar down, it could be top to bottom, or bottom to top, or right to left, or it could be diagonal. However, the gradient will move in a straight line. So you have a look over here on the gradient panel. This is the actual gradient here, or this is called the gradient slider. So here we can change the gradient, so we can say where one color stops, or where one color starts and where it stops, and we can also specify the colors to use. So we've got a gradient here that starts with white and it ends with black, so there's only 2 points on this gradient slider. We can double click on these colors, so I'll double click on the little white point here, and we can pick a different color from a swatch. So I might start with blue. If we go back to this color panel here, we can change the blue a little bit. So I might make it a dark blue, maybe a little bit lighter than that. Okay, and then I'll click out of that and I'll go over to this black color over here, and I might make it just blue again, but this time it's going to be a little bit lighter. All right, so we can use our color panel as well. All right, there we go. So we're going from a dark blue up here to a light blue down here. Now, while I still have the gradient tool selected, I can just click and drag, holding the mouse down, and I can hold down shift if I want to keep this a straight line. And so we've got from top to bottom, it goes darker blue down to a lighter blue. All right, now that could be a sky background. So we could use that to fill a scene, and we could have that as our background, just a sky background. Okay, that's linear. So linear is where the gradient moves across a line. Radial is kind of like a circle. So we have one color starting from the middle and it goes out from the middle out to a different color. Okay, so I'll just grab the gradient tool again, and we can see here we have a radius here, so we're starting with dark blue here and then light blue out here, and it's all around like a circle. Okay, so basically we can change the gradient based on how long the lines are and in what direction they go. All right, so a short line is just a small gradient and a long line is a much more gradual gradient. Okay, so that's radial. All right, those are the two different types of gradients that we'll work with, linear and radial. And you can also add on extra points on the gradient bar. So if you just click at the bottom of the bar, and you'll see the mouse cursor has a little plus on it, that will add an extra point, and you can move that point backwards and forwards. You can add a whole heap of other points if you want and change them around a little bit. And of course, you can change the color of those points. So if you click on one, you could pick a different color. Okay, and you can just change the color of all these different stop points on the gradient bar, on the gradient slider. Okay, so that's basically how to work with gradients in Adobe Illustrator. Thanks for watching.